Okay, I think it's good now. Okay, so good evening, everyone. Welcome to the class. I hope you enjoy the weekend. Did you enjoy your weekend, Blanca? ¿Disfrutó el fin de semana? Did you enjoy the weekend?
No mucho.
No. Why not? Why not, Blanca? What happened?
Un problemita de salud de mi esposo.
Ah, okay. That is why you have to take care of him. Le tocó cuidarlo.
Sí, todos los días.
Ah, okay. Yes, that is difficult and tiring. Puede ser algo cansado to take care of someone.
Sí.
Okay. Well, nice to have you here, Blanca. Lily, what about you? How was your weekend? Was it good, Lily? A good weekend?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Because your face says something different. Su cara como que no mucho me convence. So yes.
Estoy pensando cómo decírselo, lo que
hice. That is why. I'm going to take the attendance y en eso lo piensa. Voy a tomar la asistencia y ya luego me dice. Okay, so we start with Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ana Lilian.
Present.
Okay. Blanca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Brian Javier.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth. Frida Mejía. José Galileo.
Present.
Thank you. José Rodrigo. Laura Carolina. Luis Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Concepción.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. María Elena, driving. María Ivania.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Nelson Gavarrete. Omar Francisco. Thank you, Nelson. Omar Arnulfo.
Doctor.
Zaira Larín.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. And then,
present.
Thank you. Wendy Zabaleta and Jenny.
Present, teacher.
Thank you.
Present, teacher.
Christian Ernesto. Jose Arnoldo. Jose Jonathan. Juan Carlos Rivas. And Mayra Moreno.
Present, teacher. Voy
thank
you. Good present.
Thank you.
Present, okay. Teacher.
Thank you. So let's continue. Good evening, everyone, for the ones who just joined the class.
Good
Lily,
evening, teacher.
Are you ready before we continue? Did you think?
Good evening, teacher.
Hi,
good evening, everyone.
Welcome, Arnoldo.
I spend time with my family.
You spend time with your family.
Sunday, I went with my son a pizza. ¿Cómo decir que dormí mucho?
And I slept a long time.
I slept.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Lily, thank you for telling us. Well, we will have, as you can see here, we have a tongue twister. The idea is that we practice fluency, at least with some of you. I'm going to say it, and the idea is that you say it as fast as you can. Tenemos un trabalenguas acá que lleva el objetivo de practicar fluidez y que ustedes lo digan lo más rápido posible, ¿verdad? Esa es la idea, que practiquemos fluency. So I'm going to start. First, in a normal pace. Vamos a empezar normal para que escuchen la pronunciación. Betty bought some butter. But she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my butter, it will make my butter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my butter better. Okay? That's it. That's the twister, the tongue twister. Okay, now faster. Ahora un poquito más rápido. So it says, Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my butter, it will make my butter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my butter better. That's it. Okay, so now it's your turn. Ahora vamos con ustedes. You're next. Is there a volunteer who would like to go first? O a la garduña. Galileo. Okay, Galileo.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put in my butter, it will make my butter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Thank you, Galileo. But faster, más rápido, Galileo.
Okay.
Again.
Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put in my butter, it will make my butter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Okay, very well. Galileo, choose the next person. Choose the next victim. Yeah. Sorry.
Okay. Classmate. Maria Concepcion.
Maria Concepcion. Thank you. Okay, you're next. Ready? And remember, as fast as you can. Ahorita que no están diciendo, lo pueden practicar. Y aquí ya. Rápido. Okay, María Concepción.
Okay, teacher. Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the best bitter if I put it in my butter, it would make my butter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Okay, thank you. One more time, María Concepción. This one is butter. Butter.
Butter, that's okay.
Okay, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my butter, it will make my butter bitter, but a bit of better butter with my butter better.
Okay, thank you very much. So choose the next person, Maria Concepcion. Help me. Who's next?
Wendy.
Wendy. Okay, so let's continue with...
Sabino.
Okay, so Wendy, as fast as you can. O más rápido que pueda, como que lo van siguiendo.
Está María en lo que me mete. Bueno, Betty Butter bought some butter, but she saying the butter's bitter, but in my butter, it will make my butter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Butter better, okay.
Butter better, sorry.
You did very well, you did very well. Who is next, Wendy?
Okay. Jenny.
Jenny. Okay, thank you, Wendy. Jenny, let's continue, please.
Okay. Betty Butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my butter, it will make my butter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Okay, Jenny, faster, a little bit faster. Let's try again. One more time, Jenny. One more time, but faster. One, two, three.
Better butter bought some butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my butter, it will make my butter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my butter better.
Very well, good pronunciation. Jenny, choose the next person.
Carlos Antonio.
Carlos, okay, thank you, Jenny. Carlos, let's continue.
Okay. Betty butter bought some butter, but she say the butter is bitter. If I put in my butter, I will make my butter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my butter bitter.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very well, Carlos. Thank you. Thank Choose you. The next person, please. Mm. Who is next?
Brian.
Brian. Okay, thank you, Carlos. Brian, we go with a new tongue twister. Okay, this is what it says. I'll go first. I scream. You scream. We all scream for ice cream, but three times. You have to say it three times. Okay, hay que decirlo tres veces rápido. The same, Brian. So it will be ice cream, you scream. Uh-huh. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. Easy. Fácil, pa? Okay, Brian. You go first. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, go.
I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream.
There you go. Okay, Brian, thank you. Who is next?
Arnoldo.
Arnoldo. Okay, thank you, Brian. Arnoldo, we continue with you. Three times. Fast.
Okay. I scream, you scream, while screaming, I scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, while I scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, while I scream for ice cream.
Okay, that was fast. Thank you, Arnoldo. Who is next?
One moment.
Mm-hmm.
Se salvó la éxito, ¿no está? Zaira.
Zaira, okay, thank you, Arnoldo.
Okay, I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream.
Okay, thank you, Zaira. It's a little bit difficult, right? When you say it again and again and again. Zaira, you have to choose the next participant.
Okay. Laura?
Laura. Let me check. I don't see Laura. No, Laura is not here in this moment.
Ana Lilia?
Ajá, Lily is here. Okay, Lily. Let's do it.
Oh. Ay, no creo que me salga tan rápido, teacher.
Try.
Okay. I scream, you scream. We all scream for ice cream.
Ice cream.
Ice cream, you scream. We all scream for ice cream. Ice cream for ice cream.
Okay, congratulations, Lily. Thank you very much. And choose the last person. We have time for one more participant. So choose one more person, Lily.
Entendí.
Choose one person. Escoja una persona, la última.
Oh, okay. María Ivania.
Ivania. Okay, let me see. Okay. Yes, here's Ivania. Ivania, three times, fast.
Okay. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. I scream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream.
Very well. Thank you, María Ivania. Okay. We will stop because of the time, but in another moment, we will have other participants so you can also practice. So let's continue in the book. I'm going to share with you the book. Here we have it. we continue in lesson number two or unit two, that is about staff and schedules. That is what we are studying in this moment. Okay, so let's begin with Anna. Okay, Anna, question number one of the book. What is the estimated time an employee works a day in? You work in McCormick, right, Anna?
I work is for 8 hours.
Okay, that is the company. Okay, so in that company, Anna, what is the estimated, the average time an employee works in one day?
In my company general, I work 12 hours for 3 days.
Four hours.
In the weekday are 14 hours.
14. Okay. And other employees, Ana, otros empleados, other employees, the same. Lo mismo, the same.
Yes.
The same as you. And are there part-times?
It's 6 a.m. at 6 p.m. and 6 p.m. at 6 a.m. for 3 days and nights.
3 days and nights. Okay, thank you, Anna. I appreciate it. Jonathan, where do you work?
At the Status Group.
Okay, and in that company, what is the estimated time an employee works a day?
Around 9 or 10 hours a day.
9 or 10?
Yes.
That's a lot.
My department, around 9 hours because I don't work in weekend.
Weekends off. That is why you work more. Yeah. What is your schedule? What time do you start?
7:30 a.m. To 5:30.
5:30. Okay. Thank you, Jonathan. I appreciate your comment. Alfonso, what about you? Where do you work, Alfonso? Alfonso, do you?
Sorry, teacher.
Yes. What is the estimated time an employee works in your company a day? How many hours?
In my company, 8 hours, teacher.
8 hours. Do you guys have part times? Hay medios tiempos? Do you have part times in the company?
Yes. Yes, for the lunch, okay?
One hour. But people who work only 4 hours a day. Me refiero a personas que son de media jornada, no full time.
No, teacher.
No hay part times.
No hay part time. Only is in my week job is from Monday to Friday.
Monday to Friday.
Yes.
Okay, weekends off. That's a good schedule. Yes. It's a good schedule. Thank you, Alfonso, for your comment. Ellie, does everybody, question number two, Ellie, does everybody have a specific schedule to follow? Do you understand the question, Ellie? Are you there, Ellie? No. Rodrigo, what about you? Question number two, does everybody have a specific schedule to follow, Rodrigo?
No understand, teacher.
¿Será que todos tienen un horario específico? Como que todos trabajan el mismo tiempo?
Yes. today is in the AM, 5 p.m. Every day is the Monday, Friday, Saturday, AM, 12 p.m.
So, Rodrigo, there is no other option. No hay otra opción. Todos
no,
igual.
No.
The same schedule.
Yes.
Okay, Rodrigo, thank you. Let's ask Juan Carlos. Is it the same in your case, in your company?
It's the same, teacher.
What is from the schedule? Uh-huh.
From 8 a.m. to 5 or 6 p.m. From Mondays and to
Fridays
and Saturdays part-time.
Mm-hmm. From 8 to 12,
correct.
Uh-huh. Okay, so there's no different schedules. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Nelson, are you there, Nelson?
Hello.
Hi, Nelson. Does everybody have a specific schedule to follow in your company?
Yes, in the work company, 8 hours.
8 hours. And is it the same for everyone? Es la misma para todos.
Yes.
The same. What is the schedule, Nelson?
Hello?
¿Cuál es el horario? What is the schedule?
It's 8 a.m. Perdón.
Mm-hmm.
To 5 p.m. P.m. Yes.
Okay, Nelson. It's the most common schedule for most people. Mm-hmm. Okay, Nelson. Thank you for your comment. We will continue with the conversation. I'm going to read the conversation and then we will practice with some of you. So it's between Ben and Matthew. It says, hey, Matthew, how is it going? Very good, Ben. I'm relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know. You're right. Look, who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend? According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have the morning and afternoon shift, and Tom and Kate have the evening shift. Okay, so remember, relieved, that's the pronunciation of this word, relieved. And the one here, schedule. Let's go with Blanca and Laura. Blanca, you are Ben, and Laura, you are Matthew.
Okay.
Hey, Matthew, how is it going?
Very good, Ben. I am relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know.
You're right, look. Who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend?
According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have the morning and afternoon shift, and Tom and Kay have the evening shift.
Okay, thank you, Laura and Blanca. You did very well. Just, can you say this one again, Laura?
Relieved.
Uh-huh, yes, relieved. Yes, that's the way it sounds. Relieved, shift, schedule.
Schedule.
Mm-hmm. That one is a little bit Okay. Different, right? Because it doesn't sound the way you spell it out. No, no suena como se escribe. It's different.
Okay.
Thank you. We will continue with Oscar and Ellie. Oscar, you are Ben. Ellie, Matthew.
Hey, Matthew. How is going?
Very good, Ben. I really that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know.
You're right. Look, who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend?
According to this tour, Mark and Sophie have the morning and afternoon shift. And Tom and Kay have evening shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good pronunciation. Thank you, both of you. Mm-hmm.
Teacher, how do you pronounce Sophie?
Sophie.
In English?
Sophie.
Sophie. Mm-hmm. And Kate? Kate.
Kate.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Okay, now let's listen to Ivania. Ivania and Brian. Ivania, you are Ben, and Brian, you are Matthew.
Okay, teacher. Hi, Matt. Who is going?
Very good, Ben. I am relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know?
You are right. Look, who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend?
According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have the morning and after shift. Anton and Kate have the evening shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Brian and Ivania. Now let's listen to Galileo and Maria Concepcion. Galileo, you go first. You are Ben. And Maria Concepcion, okay. You are Matthew.
Okay. Hey, Matthew. How is it going?
Very good, Ben. I am relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know.
You're right. Look, who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend?
According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have the morning and afternoon shift, and Tom and Ted have the evening shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good fluency. Let's continue with Carlos. Carlos and Jenny. Carlos, you are Ben, and Jenny, Matthew. Okay, Carlos, you can start.
Hey, Matthew. How is it going?
Very good, Ben. I'm relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know?
You are right. Look, who has the early and late shift for the coming weekend?
According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have to do morning and afternoon shift, and Tom and Kate have the evening shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. One last time, we will continue with Jonathan. Let's do it one more time, Jonathan and Arnoldo.
Okay. Hey, Matthew, where is it going?
Very good, Ben. I'm relieved that everybody is here today because of the traffic, you know.
You're right. Look, who has the early and late shift for this coming weekend?
According to the schedule, Mark and Sophie have the morning and afternoon shift, and John and Kate have the evening shift.
Mm-hmm. Okay, it sounded very well. So thank you for your participation and good pronunciation. Do you have questions about the vocabulary? Questions about the vocabulary? Is there something I can help you with?
Yes, teacher.
Uh-huh.
In chip.
Chip.
Turno. Turno de. Mm-hmm. Turno. Mm.
Yes.
Es que como he visto que dice relationship.
Relationship. Mm-hmm. But That one is a little bit different. It is like this relationship. And this is shift.
Not compete.
But yes, thanks. Ellie, that is what it means. Is there anything else that I could help you with? Vocabulary questions? No? No questions.
No means.
Okay. So let's check here. We have a restaurant schedule. And I'm going to tell you who we have here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different job positions. We have the cashier, the cook, the manager, the order taker, and the waiter. And here you have the moments or the time they work, 11 a.m., 12 p.m., and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 p.m. So you can see when they have to work, the occupation they have, and the moment they work. Question number one, it says, who manages the restaurant? Rodrigo, what do you think? Who manages the restaurant based on the schedule?
Manager is Jennifer Rodriguez.
Yes, Jennifer Rodriguez. She's the manager of the restaurant.
Yes.
Thank you. And then we have question number two. Who cooks? What do you think about that question, Alfonso? Who cooks?
Kevin Dolly.
Karen
Dolly. Karen Dolly. And Linda Harris.
Correct. Four Linda cooks, Harris. Right? Kevin, Karen, Mateo, and Linda. Cook is not only a verb, it's also an occupation, right? Cook no es solo el verbo, sino también una ocupación. Como cocinero, right? Not chef, but cocinero. That is what it means. I have something for you. Let me just double check. Okay, I'm going to share with you a link by chat for you to watch a video. Les voy a compartir acá en el chat un link para que vean un video. After you watch the video, you have to try to tell me what are the benefits of the HAT schedule. Voy a poner aquí la pregunta que vamos a tratar de contestar. What are the
teacher,
benefits?
Podría mandarlo a WhatsApp porque yes. Yo no puedo abrir nada en mi computadora.
Yes. What are the benefits of HAT? Schedule. Okay, that is the name of the app, HAT Schedule. The video lasts 2 minutes. El video dura 2 minutos. But I advise you to watch it. And I will send it in the chat, in the group in this moment. Ahí está ya, Wendy, en el grupo. Watch it 2 times. Traten de verlo unas 2 veces y traten de ver si logran encontrar la respuesta, okay? Entonces, en unos 4 minutos, platicamos sobre él. Please watch it. We're going to see in this video. In this video is the answer. We will discuss it in one moment, Galileo. Have you finished? No.
No, teacher. It's the second.
Ah. Ready.
Ready.
Okay, guys. We will talk about the video. It's kind of difficult, but we will discuss it. So please return to Zoom. The question. Okay, let's go little by little. Vamos poco a poco. Okay. Question for Lily. Lily, are you there, Lily? I don't see you. Okay, Lily. Why do you think? By the way, in these classes, we will have less grammar and more speaking. En las siguientes clases vamos a tener más speaking. No vamos a ver mucho grammar, sino que vamos a practicar, okay? So, Lily, why is it important for companies to have schedules? In your personal opinion, why is it important for companies to have schedules? Why could it be important?
Porque es importante.
Tener horarios en las compañías.
Lo puedo decir en español.
I'll give you time to organize your thoughts. Te voy a dar tiempo, Lily, para que organice sus ideas in English, and then let me know, okay?
Hey, teacher, es que así no me salen a mí rápido.
Vamos a practicar ahorita, ya va a ver que ya vamos a mejorar speaking more. Okay, can you help us, Carlos, Juan Carlos? Sorry, Juan Carlos. Why is it important? Can you try to tell us in English?
For me, for my opinion, mm-hmm. is the correct form to the employees do it something in a determined time.
Uh-huh. Okay, Juan Carlos, thank you very much. Blanca, and you, in your personal opinion, why is it important to have schedules?
It is important for milagro, pero organization, o sea,
ah, to organize the employees. Correct. For good organization, it's good. It's good to have employees. Do you want to add something else? ¿Quiere agregar algo más? Do you want to add something else?
Me cuesta. ¿Cómo decirlo en inglés?
Okay. We will practice. Ya verán. Vamos a hacer más speaking. I want you to speak.
Teacher.
Speak more. Hey, yes, Juan Carlos.
Health schedule, what does mean?
Ahorita vamos, ahorita solo quiero escuchar a Lily y ya vamos a ver eso. So, Lily, what is your answer?
It's important because it's why of organize to meet is schedule and that client no the horse in with the can the attendant.
Okay, Lily, thank you. Thank you for your effort and your comment. Okay, so hat schedules. Jonathan, what is that? Can you tell us? Juan Carlos wants to know and Galileo too. So it's on the video. So Jonathan, what is that? What is the meaning of hat schedule? Maybe Jonathan is not there. Ah, Jonathan. What is the meaning of hat schedule? ¿Qué significa eso de hat schedule?
Half.
Lo que está en el chat.
Ah, okay, sorry.
It's in the chat. Galileo sent the question.
Meaning hat schedule. I don't have any idea.
No idea. Okay, who has an idea? Galileo, you have one.
Teacher, according to the video, I think hot schedule is when the clients come to the business, like a restaurant, for example. I think the hot schedule is when the workers, the company have a lot of workers in between 12 and 2 p.m., for example. In El Salvador, in Papa John's, we say horas pico. Yeah, I think that is the meaning of our schedule to increase the efficiency.
Okay, Galileo, thank you for your comment. Arnoldo, do you have a comment? Hat schedule.
Yes, maybe. I think that hat schedule make a big difference in the organized and efficient to the company. For example, in a old job that I have, we changed the times in the efficiency get up
increase
yeah, we work before 12 hours per day. And after the team, we make team work, and everything work only 8 hours per day. And the result is bigger. The efficient increases in so high. In the video, one person say that the whole schedule saving time and increases efficiency. And the team, we are connecting all time.
Okay, Arnoldo, thank you. Is there any other comment? Do you have any other ideas? Hat schedule? What do you imagine it is? Do you agree with Arnoldo? Do you agree with Galileo? What is hat schedule for you? Any other comments?
In the video, I think it is application.
An application.
An application for managers, people with a schedule when it's very demand of service.
Okay, Jonathan, sure. Thank you.
In my opinion, maybe it's un horario pesado.
A heavy schedule.
Yes, a heavy schedule.
Okay, Ellie, thank you. And Zaira, did you have a comment before we say what it is?
My opinion, maybe there are times that restaurants have more movimiento, movement.
Aha, movement. Okay, Zaira, thank you. So maybe you also have an idea, the ones who haven't mentioned it, but yes, it is an application. Hat schedule is not a word in English, it's an app. It's an app that companies use. It is an application companies use. As Arnoldo, I think it was Arnoldo, that they use to promote efficiency. Efficiency and organization. They use the app to organize the staff or the personnel. Now, question number two, what are the benefits? Maybe you heard the benefits of that. Let's begin with Oscar Arnulfo. What are the benefits of hat schedule?
One of benefits is the best organization for the employees, but the goals of the enterprise.
Okay, thank you, Wendy. And for you, what are the benefits you could understand?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. For the app, the work is very fast.
What do you mean?
For example, write the order is very slow. In app, is very fast.
Ah, okay, the efficiency.
Efficiency, yes.
Efficiency. Okay, Wendy, thank you. Maria Concepcion, what are the benefits of that app?
It's one organization. No sé cómo se dice.
Which word? ¿Qué palabra, María Concepción?
Que se ve que son una empresa bastante organizada, que tienen una organización y unos empleados bastante interesante y tienen como dos o tres personas, manager, que están encargados de tequilas, tacos. Entonces tienen.
Okay. Uh-huh. Tienen. But yes, you can say that they have order or organization. Maybe you can say that they have good organization to organize the employees. Who sells tacos, who sells different things. So yes, and everyone can see that. Is there anybody else? Did any of you heard other comments? No sé si hay algún otro comentario que tal vez no hayan dado sus compañeros about the app.
Ajá. Teacher.
Yes, teacher. Carlos.
About
and Jen. Okay. Ajá, Carlos.
The more customer is the more money or for the employees, more the cheap possibility.
Mm-hmm. Correct. Because you can also check overtime. También ahí pueden ver si hay tiempo para hacer tiempo extra. Así que, ajá, les ayuda también a los employees. Jenny, did you have a comment?
Yes, teacher. Hmm? I think the schedule them separate the time to work of the time free of the personnel. When in time to work, the personnel have to concentrate of the objectives for the company.
Mm-hmm.
In separate, pues the time free of the time to work.
True, that's correct. Thank you, Jenny. Okay, thank you for your comments. We will continue. We will be working in, there are two activities. I sent something by chat here on Zoom and also on WhatsApp. I sent a worksheet that we will be using. And yes, Oscar, thank you for the comment as well. I just read it. But first, before we work on that, we will work on this. In groups of three, we have to check the book, check the schedule, and you have to answer five questions about the schedule. Vamos a estar trabajando en grupos de tres y vamos a contestar las preguntas que aparecen acá en la página 24. There are five of them. Hay cinco preguntas que son en base al horario que ven acá, on page 23. Vamos a trabajar primero en esto y luego vamos a seguir con la otra activity. Do you have questions about this activity? No sé si hay dudas, questions about this point. No? We're fine?
En esa tengo dudas.
Ajá. ¿En cuál, Blanca?
23.
Ajá. ¿Cuál es la duda, Blanca?
El cuadro. ¿A qué no pasamos ahí?
¿Cómo? No entiendo bien.
No entiendo el cuadro.
Ah, no entiende el cuadro. Ajá. Ah, ok, Blanca. Voy a llegar a su room, a su sala. Y tal vez también sus compañeros, ya viéndolo más detalladamente, pueden tratar de entenderlo, ajá, porque está okay. Así. Y luego vas, ajá.
Question.
Yes, Jonathan, ajá.
Is the schedule, the box is the schedule?
Yes, that's the schedule. Este es el schedule, el que está on page 23. Y lo que van a contestar son las preguntas que están on page 24. Donde dice, read the schedule again and answer the questions below. Mm-hmm. Elena, do you have a question, Elena?
Yes, and the page 22.
Aha. Uh-huh. What about page 22?
The 22, no. In the schedule?
The schedule 22. Is on page 23. Questions next, page 24, in the superior side. Yes?
Oh, yes.
Okay. I'm going to take the attendance and then I'm going to let you go. I'm going to take the attendance really quick. Remember to have the camera on and to say present, please. Let's start with Ana. Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Lilian.
Present.
Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Brian Carmona.
Present.
Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth.
Present, Frida. Teacher. Sorry.
Okay.
Present.
Thank you. Frida Janine. Jose Galileo.
Present.
And then Jose Rodrigo.
Present.
Laura Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Luis Alfonso. María Concepción.
Present.
Sorry.
Thank you. Okay, Alfonso. María Elena.
Present.
María Ivania.
Present.
Nelson Gabarrete.
Present.
Okay. Omar Francisco. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Okay, then we have Zaira Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Wendy Maribel.
Present, teacher.
Jenny Zuleima.
Present, teacher.
Cristian Ernesto. Jose Arnoldo.
Present, miss.
Jose Jonathan.
Present, miss.
Juan Carlos Rivas.
Present.
Okay, thank you. And Mayra Moreno. Okay, so now let's create the rooms. Hold on. Please open the rooms. Accept the invite.
Jorge Milano and Carlos.
And Carlos Guardián.
Yes. Who is in charge of managing the restaurant? Manager Jennifer Rodriguez is only one.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, I'm visiting you. Visiting you a moment. Is there something I can help you with?
No.
Ah, okay. I'm going to stay with you just a moment. I'm just going to listen to you a moment, and then I'm going to.
Okay.
I'm going to leave.
Okay. Number one, who is the chair of wait table in the morning shift? Is Jorge Milano and Carlos Guardián.
It's correct.
Number two,
who is in charge of managing the restaurant?
The restaurant. Jennifer Rodriguez. Yes. Jennifer Rodriguez, number two.
Number two.
Who is the chair of the kitchen in the morning shift? Who? The brothers, Kevin and Karen.
Yes, Kevin and Karen Dolly.
Okay. It's possible his brother.
It's possible.
Cuando, teacher, en español, cuando es varón y mujer, que son hermanos, ¿qué es lo correcto, brothers?
No, siblings. Siblings is siblings. Both. Brothers, sibling, only boys.
Sibling, sibling es como familiar.
No, that is relatives.
Siblings is a woman, or men.
Or men.
Pero sí. Uh-huh. Ah, ya me recordé ya. Sibling no solo se ocupa para pareja como esposo.
Romántico.
No.
Ajá.
No.
Así es.
No, siblings are hermanos, but both sex.
Okay, sí.
Ajá. Siblings. Brothers only men and sisters only women.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. That's the one.
No me recordaba de esa, de sibling, couple, and había otra. No me recuerdo. Pero sigamos.
Ajá, there are a lot, yes.
Strange, creo que era, no me recuerdo.
Strangers.
Ajá.
Strangers.
The video. It's in the video. Mm-hmm. Workless class.
Yes. The couple, okay. Siblings, and strange.
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Strangers. Uh-huh. Yes, that one is.
Okay.
Is another number one.
Number four, Maria Elena.
Number four. Say, who is in charge of taking orders during the morning shift?
Taking orders.
Orders. Taking orders.
Taking
orders is Jorge Milano and Carlos Guardián.
Ah, esa es la número cuatro.
En la dos y la tú es waiters.
Tool.
Ah, ya me mandó.
Hi, how are you doing?
Teacher, ¿me puede enviar a la sala? Dice que acabo de ingresar desde la computadora y me mandó a otra sala, a la 4.
Ah, ok. ¿En qué sala estaba, Jonathan?
¿Con
quién?
Aquí con ellos.
No, pero antes.
Sí, aquí está. Aquí está con nosotros.
Brian, con...
Antes de que lo mandara para acá, estaba aquí siempre.
Sí. No, sí. Pero es que empezó a entrar a la computadora, desde la computadora, y me mandó, pero a la sala 4 con Zaira.
Ah, ya. Ok. Y esta es, déjeme revisar, sala...
Y así me salgo del celular.
Ok. Ok, ahí está, Jonathan. ¿Qué tal van? ¿Ya casi terminan? ¿O ya terminaron? No.
Only number five.
Solo eso, les falta ya.
Yes.
Ah, ok. Ok, good. Ok, so in 2 minutes, in that case, in 2 minutes, we will go back to the main room. Okay, see you in 2 minutes. Bye. Okay, we will wait just a moment for your classmates to come back, and then we check the answers. Okay, everyone, welcome. We will check the answers. We will check the answers that you got. So we start with question number one. Group number two, Galileo, Concepcion, and Nelson. Question number one, who is in charge of waiting tables in the morning? Galileo,
Teacher, Walter Omo and Matthew Tsur.
Walter and Matthew. They are in charge of waiting tables in the morning.
Okay.
Matthew and Walter. Okay, all right, thank you. Let's listen to Jonathan. Do you have the same as Galileo? Do you have the same information? Question number one.
Walter Olmo.
Walter and Matthew? No.
Yes, Walter and Matthew.
Walter and Olmo and Matthew. Matthew. Okay, thank you. And Rodrigo, what about you?
Yes, number one. Walter Olmo, Matthew Tull.
Walter and Matthew. Okay, thank you. That is correct. Let's continue with question number two. Who is in charge of managing the restaurant? Let's listen to Wendy. Who is in charge?
Okay, two. Who is in charge? Name the restaurant. Miss Jennifer Rodriguez.
Jennifer Rodriguez. Thank you, Wendy. And you, Laura, do you have the same information as Wendy?
Yes, is managing who managing is Jennifer Rodriguez.
Jennifer Rodriguez. Yes. So if you have Jennifer Rodriguez, that's correct. She's the one. Thank you, Laura. Question number three. Let's listen to Juan Carlos Rivas. Who is in charge of the kitchen in the morning? Who is in charge of the kitchen in the morning?
In the morning, the cook is Kevin Dolly.
Kevin.
And Karen Dolly.
Kevin and Karen. Okay, thank you, Juan Carlos. Zaira, what do you have? Number three.
And Kevin and Karen.
Kevin and Karen. Okay, thank you. Ivania, and your group, number three.
And Karen, darling, and Kevin and Karen.
Okay, thank you. So if you have the same, yes, that's the one. Thank you. Let's continue with number four. Let's listen to Ellie. Who is in charge of taking orders during the morning shift? Number four, Ellie. Are you there, Ellie? Ellie.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Tell us.
Number four. In the morning. Is Jorge and Carlos Guardia.
Jorge and Carlos. Thank you very much. And let's double check now with, let me see, Jenny Suleyma. Do you have the same information?
Yes,
Number four?
Yes, teacher.
The, yes, same. The same. Carlos and Walter. And
Jorge Milan.
Okay. Carlos, I'm sorry, and Jorge. Yes, I apologize. Okay, so if all of you have the same, that is correct. You have the right answer. And then we have question number five. Let's listen to Arnoldo. What does Matthew do?
He is a waiter.
He is a waiter. Thank you. And you, Elena, what does Matthew do?
I think the same. He is the waiter and the morning chief.
He is. Uh-huh. Very specific. Do you have questions about any of the answers? Questions about the schedule? No, no questions. Okay, Blanca, ¿y si la entendió al final, Blanca? Al schedule. Ya no sí, logré llegar ahí.
Me explicó él.
I'm glad. Sorry, que ya no fui por allá. Okay, so let's continue with the next schedule, the one I sent in the group. Okay, so this is the one that I sent by chat. It says work schedule is similar. You have Smith, Sue, Jones, and Ed. And I'm going to magnify it. And you have to answer six questions about them. What are the name of the employees listed on the schedule? What days does Sue and Smith have off? You have six questions and you have the word schedule. Okay, va a ser similar, pero ahora es con otros. Other people, other questions. Do you have questions for me before I divide you? Doubts, dudas about that exercise? No. Okay, just one comment. You won't be able to annotate there. No van a poder anotar ahí, así que les recomiendo notebook, porque no van a poder ahí. I'm going to open the rooms again, so you can go back to work with your group. Hello, now I'm here. Hoy sí viene para acá, Blanca. I'm going to stay with you a moment. Me voy a quedar aquí escuchándolos un momento. Okay, and if you need me, you can let me know. Ustedes comparten la pantalla usualmente.
En este momento, no. Ahorita voy a compartir.
Ah, ok. Ah, ok.
Okay, you can see the page.
Nope.
¿Pueden ver la pantalla?
No.
What?
No.
Okay, one more. Ah. Ya sé qué pasó.
No se puede, Armando.
Buen momento, ahorita.
Ah, ok.
Okay. Okay. You can see the.
Yeah.
The picture. Okay.
Lo puede acercar. Ajá.
Okay. Word. Okay. Number one, what are the names on the employees listed? of this schedule?
Sue Smith and Ed Jones.
Yeah. Right? Sue Smith and Ed Jones. Blanca, number two. What days does Sue Smith have off? ¿Qué día va a descansar? Thursdays and Friday.
Why?
Correct. A ver, Duet and Sue will have to work on the weekend? Yes. Ed, no, yes, they work. They work on the weekend.
How many days then?
Okay, Blanca, how many days does Ed have to work the week of June 10th? Teacher, this is an error.
Which one?
Number four, how many days?
No. Monday, why do Monday. You think so?
¿Cuánto?
¿Cuántos días trabaja? ¿Tiene de trabajo en la semana?
Ajá.
En junio.
Yes. That's the question.
Sería. Oops.
O en texto, algo así, vaya para. Poder escribir.
Yes, I'm sorry. Por eso les mencionaba que no se podía. Porque es una foto. It's a picture. Entonces, por eso no pueden. Por eso no se puede.
Editar, no se puede editar.
Para que practiquen. Entonces, por eso lo hice así, para que no usaran la compu. No usaran el notebook. How are you doing? Do you need help? Do you have questions for me?
The number is of schedule the of book.
Sorry, again, Zaira.
Los nombres que pide son los de libro.
No, the ones you have here. No, the ones you have in this worksheet. Or document.
Okay.
¿Y dónde está el cuadro, teacher? Ah, ese es, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Ese.
Yes.
Okay, what are the name of the employee listed on the schedule? Estamos hablando de Sue Smith and John Ed.
Yes, Smith
John
Ed.
And John Ed. What day does Sue Smith have off?
Eso, ¿dónde se pide?
Blanco, por ese, as for
help. How can I help you, Jenny?
Help, teacher.
Yes, tell me. What can I do for you?
We don't understand the question five.
Question five. Okay.
It's similar question two for us.
It's similar. It's the same. It's the same, but 2 days. So, 2 days off.
2 days. Oh,
let me breathe again.
Okay.
Question number four, right? Or number five? Number five.
Five. Similar to.
Okay. What 2 days off does Sue have to work? What 2 days off has Sue have to work? Es como que dos días libres tiene que trabajar Sue. ¿Cuáles son los 2 días libres en los que Sue tiene que trabajar?
Entonces es Saturday and Sunday. No.
Thursday and Friday son sus day off.
¿Pero por qué tiene que trabajar?
Ajá.
Si no trabaja, no entiendo.
Let me see. 2 days off she has to work. Pues, what? Then, sería que no. She doesn't have to. Porque no, no dice ahí que tenga que trabajar.
Tiene que trabajar.
Como que si no. O sea que los tiene libres.
Ajá.
Está confusa.
Ajá, sí, es para que no se duerman.
Hoy estoy bien despierta.
Ya los viernes ya todas las energías han bajado. Pero hoy sí todos tienen bastante.
Sí.
Okay. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Only that.
Okay. So in 2 minutes we will be back, okay? In 2 minutes. See you there.
Okay.
Hi, Brian. Okay, now that you are back, we are going to compare. Okay, we're going to compare answers to see if we have the same. We start with Laura. Laura, question number one. What are the names of the employees listed on this schedule? What are the names, Laura?
Sorry. The employee list of this chat schedule are Sue Smith and Jones L. Sue Smith y el Jones.
Sue
and Smith. Jones L. L. Jones.
Sue Smith and Ed
Jones.
Jones. Okay, yes. Thank you. So, okay, here we have the answer. And let's check with Carlos. Question number one. What is the answer you guys have? What are the names of the employees listed on this schedule?
Yes. Smith, Sue, Jones, and Ed.
Four people in that case.
Yes.
Four people.
Four
people. And Laura, two people. In your group two and in your group four. Okay, let's check. Jenny, Wendy, and Oscar, what are the names? What are the names of the people?
Yes. What are the names?
For you, two people. Yes,
Sue,
Ira.
Sue Smith and Ed Jones.
Thank you. Do you have a comment, Ira? Just activate the microphone. Oops, sorry. I don't hear you, Saira. Now I hear you. Question one.
Question one. And Sue Smith, John L.
So in total, two people, Saira.
Two
people. Okay. And Jonathan, what do you say, Jonathan? Thank you,
only
Saira.
Only two people.
Yes. So Carlos
and Ed Jones.
Yes, Smith only two Jones people.
Are second as
The surnames. You can say surnames. Apellidos are the surnames. Thank you. Arnoldo, do you have a comment?
Yes, teacher. In the list name. For the order, if in the surname first and the names is separate with a comma.
Correct.
Only are two people.
Two people. Yes. Thank you, Arnoldo. Question number two. Let's continue with. Let's check here. Nelson, what days does Sue Smith have off? What days does Sue Smith have off?
Thursday and Friday.
Thursdays and Fridays. Okay, thank you, Nelson. Let's compare. Let's listen to Blanca. Question number two. What is the answer for you? Blanca?
Tuesday and Friday.
Thursdays and Fridays. Sue Smith. She doesn't work on Thursdays and Fridays. Okay. And you, Ivania? Number two.
Thursday and Friday.
Correct. So yes, the answer is Thursdays and Fridays. Thank you. Correct answer. Question number three. Let's listen now to Alfonso. Do Ed and Sue both have to work on the weekends? Do they have to work on the weekends, Alfonso?
Yes, they do, chica.
Yes, they do. Okay. So Alfonso says, yes, they do. And what about you, Elena? Do they have to work on the weekends? Yes or no?
Yes, they are.
Yes, they are. Okay, thank you. And now let's see, Anna, what do you say?
Yes, they are, teacher.
They are. Okay, thank you. The answer is yes. In this case, do. Do because it is simple present. And we have do here. So yes, they do. Jonathan?
Yes, they do, but Ed doesn't work on Sunday.
Ed doesn't. Why do you say that? ¿Por qué dices eso, Jonathan?
Ah, sorry. Me equivoqué. Pensé que Sunday.
Ah, okay. Yes, they both work Sundays and Saturdays. Okay, thank you. Next question, number four. How many days does Ed have to work the week of June? Now let's listen first to Maria Concepcion. Question number four.
6 days of the week.
Six days. Okay, let's check. Lily, how many days, Lily? Ed? Lily? Or Juan Carlos?
How many days does mm-hmm. Ed have to work the week of June 10? Two days.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Let's double check. Are you there, Oscar? Question number four.
She wore 6 days.
6 days. Uh-huh. That is the answer. Sorry, do you have a comment, Arnoldo?
No more.
No, that was the comment. And you, Jonathan?
No, miss.
No. Okay, so yes, he has to work 6 days of the week. That will be the answer. 6 days, Ed. Question number five was a little bit confusing, right? Question number five. Let's double check. What 2 days off does Sue have to work? Let's listen to Galileo.
I think Sue doesn't have to work in her 2 days off because in the schedule appeared off.
Okay, so you said no. None. Ninguno. Okay, yeah. Thank you, Galileo. Let's listen to Elena and Carlos. What was the answer you gave? ¿Qué dijeron ustedes? Number five.
I think so. Thursday 30 and Friday 40 is the free day.
Days off. Entonces, ¿sí trabajaría esos días o no?
No.
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 Are you sure? ¿Segura?
Yes, is it free? Yes, is it free? Is 3 days.
Days off. Okay, thank you. Zaira, one last comment. Number five, what 2 days off does Sue have to work? Just activate the microphone.
La confundí, teacher.
Ah.
Con la okay. Número dos. Y le puse que era Thursday and Friday.
Thursdays and Fridays. Okay, well, the answer is None, ninguno, right? She doesn't have to work the days off. No tiene que trabajar en sus días libres. Okay, thank you. And last question. We have question number six. Question number six. Ellie, what day do Ed and Sue work the same shift together? What day do Ed and Sue work the same shift together?
Se me olvidó. Wednesday.
Wednesday. Okay, thank you. And Rodrigo, do you have the same opinion?
Wednesday.
Wednesday. Okay, Jonathan.
On Wednesday.
Wednesdays. And Arnoldo? Wednesdays?
Ed and Sue work together on Wednesdays.
They work together on Wednesdays. Thank you. Ajá, those were the answers. It was a little bit tricky. Estaba un poquito engañoso, but you did it very well. Last activity. We have one last activity. And now in this moment, you have to create a sketch wall. Activity number six of the book. Okay, activity number six. Prepare a mini presentation about sketch wall activities of four to five employees do at your workplace. In other words, you have to create your company. You and your group have to create a company. You're going to have four employees and you have to create the job sketch wall. Okay, van a crear en este caso su compañía, puede ser a bank, restaurant, hospital, clinic, you choose, pueden escoger lo que ustedes quieran. Entonces tienen su compañía y van a crear su sketch wall. Pueden tomar como base este, si ustedes quieren personalizarlo más, lo pueden hacer. Pero tienen que presentar su sketch wall de trabajo. Esta es una idea. Do you have questions? Doubts, dudas, questions? Do we understand? ¿Entendemos lo que vamos a hacer?
Sería con la misma cantidad de personas o más.
Four people will be enough. Con cuatro estaría bien. Y esta es una idea, ¿verdad? Hay que crear un sketch wall. Y ustedes escogen qué va a ser, ¿verdad? Si el tipo de trabajo o la compañía. Y depende de eso, ya ponen las job positions, ¿verdad? Si van a haber managers, si van a haber waiters. Depende de qué compañía sean, ustedes ponen las ocupaciones o las posiciones. ¿Ok? All right. En caso que no terminemos para presentarlos, entonces me mandan ese job schedule en el chat, ¿verdad? Del grupo. I will visit you. Ahí llego en un momento a visitarlos.
Para decir, teacher, lleva cena.
bring us dinner. Bring us dinner.
Ok, bring us dinner, please.
Una virtual les voy a llevar. Así como la clase. Virtual dinner. Alfonso, who were you working with, Alfonso? ¿Con quién estaba trabajando? Veo que se le desconectó su device. Alfonso.
Hola, teacher. Sí, tiene problema. Perdón que tengo problema ahorita.
Ajá, creo que tiene que desconectar uno de los dos dispositivos o alejarlos.
Me metí. ¿Para qué? Se me cayó la señal de la casa y me conecté con el celular y ahorita no sé cómo salirme.
Ok, ¿cuál quiere que saque? Yo saco el que usted quiera. ¿Cuál le saco? ¿Del que está hablando o del que no está hablando?
El celular.
¿Está hablando ahorita con el celular? ¿Es este el celular? Porque si es este con el que estaba hablando, Alfonso, le saco este dispositivo. porque hay dos, pero no me permite ver cuál es el celular y cuál es el otro. ¿Cuál es, Alfonso, el teléfono?
No sé, teacher.
Voy a sacar uno, entonces. Voy a sacar uno y si no, vemos. Ok. Ahora ya está solo uno.
Gracias, gracias. Ajá,
you're welcome. Sí, distrae, se siente bien raro cuando se oye la repetición así.
Gracias.
Bien feo. Ok, ¿con quién estaba trabajando, Alfonso?
Está con Rodrigo y con Zaira.
Rodrigo y Zaira. Ah, ok. Le voy a enviar ahí una invitation.
Por favor.
What happened, Jonathan? Se le volvió a desconectar su device. I don't hear you.
No tenía carga, teacher.
Por eso. Ok, lo voy a enviar a su room.
Okay, solo gracias.
Estaba con quién, recuérdame, please.
María Ibáñez, creo.
Ok.
Aquí estoy, teacher.
También Esteban aquí.
Me sacó o me salí por
el... ¿Y con quién más estaban? Porque
nosotros
ustedes dos. Ah.
Sí.
Ah, ok.
En el room one.
Ajá. Ok, ahí está la invite.
Cuatro nombres.
Four names. Teacher, how was dinner?
Hi, teacher.
Delicious. Hi. Ya me la comí yo. It was delicious. I ate Hawaiian pizza. And your dinner, how was it?
Tengo un dilema, teacher. Sí, va a ser, pero como es lo horario, es que queríamos hacerlo como de una clínica por 7 días, el horario, pero okay. Para sin poner cargos o solo los nombres de las personas.
Sí, tienen que poner el cargo.
Okay.
Si es nurse, doctor.
Teacher, lo vamos a presentar mañana entonces, teacher.
No, si no queda tiempo, solo voy a ver el
porque ya lo estamos haciendo, pero estamos inventando, teacher. Nos cuesta usar la compu.
Ok, don't worry.
Ok.
Take your time.
Ok. ¿Cuál día sigue? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
Thursday.
Thursday. Ay, teacher. Pensé que ya se había ido, teacher.
No, I'm still here.
Okay.
Teacher, ¿cómo teacher? Se dice, no he cenado aún.
I haven't eaten my dinner yet.
Sería un gerundio, ¿verdad?
Es un participio.
Un participio.
Mm-hmm. I haven't eaten my dinner yet. ¿Come tarde, Juan Carlos?
No, this time I'm asleep.
Ah, prefirió dormirse. Sí. Y come. Ah, bueno.
Pero ya verá cenar.
Ajá, sí, ya me imagino que ya ha de estar el estómago con hambre. ¿Eh?
Ya estoy viendo pavos.
Ok. Ok, well, I'm going to let you continue. If you need me, let me know, ok?
Thanks, teacher.
Amy, vamos a enseñar a Amy.
No sé por qué siempre me da.
Hi. How are you doing?
Aquí vamos.
Sí, con la vamos. Laptop, PowerPoint.
Yes. No sé por qué siempre me está saliendo. Why? No, ¿cómo es?
No, es el caso.
Why, es verdad.
No. Oh, ah, no, un mesero entonces.
¿El o mesero? El cajero. El cajero es primero, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. El cash. Cashen o share.
No, lleva una I en vez de la E. Lleva siempre la E. No.
Mejor, vea. Entonces, manager.
Sorry, manager. Just one comment. Sorry to interrupt. Laura estaba viendo que ahora nos tocaba la sesión privada. Se
ay,
va a poder
no
quedar.
Creo, qué feo. Ok, teacher, sí. Sí, está
¿se
bien,
va a
teacher.
Quedar? Segura, yes. Si no, podemos.
No, no, está bien los 10 minutos, teacher.
Ok.
Así okay, salgo ya de eso también. Ok. Uh-huh.
Ok, so okay. I'm going to let you continue. Solo le quería okay, avisar ahí.
Okay.
Ok, see you later.
Algo nada más. ¿De ahí qué iría?
El cargo. Pero que llevara como dos líneas antes para poner en la primera como la fecha y luego sus horas de no, la fecha sería. Y en el ahí las fechas.
Uh-huh. Sería el día.
El día, ajá. Día y fecha. Bueno, más o menos así son los que nosotros hacemos, día y fecha.
No lo entiendo. Don't understand, teacher.
Which part? ¿Qué parte, Alfonso?
Todo. No sé qué vamos a hacer.
Es un horario, Alfonso, el que tiene que crear. Podrían tomar de base el que ya estaba en el libro.
Claro.
Ajá.
Porque sí, la idea sería más fácil es que, así.
La idea es que creen uno, ¿verdad? Y que puedan
como organizarlo. El de la página 23.
Ajá.
Sí. Ok.
Sí, sería más fácil.
¿Con los mismos cargos?
Depende de la compañía que ustedes escojan, porque eso, por eso sí.
Por eso que les... yo les decía que íbamos a ocupar la compañía de Zaira.
Ah, ok, a hotel sería.
Y se llama Zaira S.A.D.C.
Yeah. Ah, wow, ok. Entonces, si es un hotel, entonces escojan cargos que hay en un hotel.
Uh-huh.
Entonces, así funcionaría.
Ok.
Y tomen como modelo el que está ahí ya creado.
Ok.
Aunque no sé la verdad si van a lograrlo, porque ya faltan como 2 minutos. Ajá. Pero que, es que vi que lo estaban cambiando, ¿verdad? Porque ahorita lo van a hacer distinto. Ajá.
Bueno, okay, si no bueno. Se trabaja, me pongo de acuerdo con los compañeros, lo trabajamos hasta las 12 de la noche, se lo mandamos.
No,
como a la
no,
una.
No. Pero, ajá, lo pueden, si no, me lo pueden mandar todavía el fin de semana, ¿verdad?
Vaya, gracias.
Ajá, en caso no, pero ahorita todavía tienen 2 minutos para que le agreguen y ya después me lo mandan en un mensaje privado todo el sketch. Okay, I'm going to let you continue, ¿verdad? Los voy a dejar que continúen y luego nos vemos ahí en about 2 or 3 minutes.
Okay, Zaira, y los cargos.
Hi, Brian. Did you have a problem with your connection? En Nelson, usted también tuvo problemas con su conexión. Hi, welcome back. How did it go, Galileo and Maria Concepcion? Did you finish?
No, a presentation, but we have a schedule, a work
you
schedule.
You have the schedule.
Can you see? Or do you want to see it?
Send it in the group or send it to me privately.
Okay.
Because of the time, we won't share them here. But at least I want to see the schedule.
Mm-hmm. Yes, only the schedule because the presentation is not finished.
Okay, yes, just the schedule. So if you finish your schedule, send it to me in the group, okay, after the class. If you didn't finish, send it to me during the week on a private message, okay, so I can double check your schedule. For the moment, I'm going to take the attendance because it's time to go. After that, I'm going to stay with Laura in the private session.
Okay,
so we start with Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Ana Lilian.
Present.
Blanca Elizabeth.
Present.
Brian Javier. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth. Frida Janine, José Galileo,
present.
José Rodrigo,
present.
Laura Carolina,
present teacher.
Luis Alfonso, María Concepción, thank you.
Present teacher.
María Elena,
I'm here teacher.
María Ivania,
present teacher.
Nelson Gavarrete.
Omar
Francisco, thank you. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Then Zaira Marlene.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Wendy Maribel.
Present teacher.
Jenny Zuleima.
Present teacher.
Cristian Ernesto. Jose Arnoldo. Jose Jonathan.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Juan Carlos Rivas.
Present teacher.
Okay. And Mayra. Mayra Moreno. Okay, everyone, that's it. Now you are free to go. Have a good night and see you tomorrow. Okay. Bye bye. Sweet dreams.
Good night. Bye.
Bye.
Bless you. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
¿Quién, ahora quién se queda?
Laura. Laura se va a quedar. ¿Se quiere quedar mañana usted? Bueno, mañana se va a quedar Omar, pero si quiere el miércoles, la puedo agendar a usted, Elena. Si gusta.
Ok.
Ok, entonces así quedamos. Wednesday.
Wednesday. Thank you. Uh-huh.
You're welcome. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, one moment, Laura.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, Laura, how are you? ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo está?
Bien, very bien. Well. Very well.
Okay, I'm glad to hear that.
Ay, no, quiero ver si puedo hablar en inglés. Ay, now, no, espéreme, hoy es today. Ah, today, now, my day off in the company is American in República Dominicana is Día de la Raza.
Race Day.
Así que holiday in.
For you,
in El Salvador. For me.
What is the company you work with?
Es State Trust Bank. Hago compañía con quién? Jonathan Vigil. Es también empleado de donde estoy trabajando.
Okay, got it. So it's a bank. Es para un banco.
Yes. Es un banco internacional.
Okay.
In the Miami tiene branch.
Yes, it sounds familiar. That's good. So you work online, desde casa, from home.
Online, yes.
Desde antes de la pandemia, before the pandemic too.
No, after.
After.
No, before, pues after of pandemic.
After the pandemic, you started to work online.
In the war,
Before the pandemic, in an office.
Sí, yes.
Okay. Do you like it from home or do you prefer to go to the office?
Tiene su ventaja, ahí ya sí, ya no puedo hablar. Ahí sí ya no puedo hablar en inglés. Ya se me acabó la idea. Le iba a decir. Tiene sus ventajas, teacher. Porque en casa uno da más del tiempo. Y en la oficina cabal tiene su horario de salida y no lo está molestando a cada momento. O sea, como saben que está uno en casa, están va de hablar y hablar.
Siente que trabaja más de su
hace
su hora.
Más horas uno.
Y no le dan el overtime, no le pagan el tiempo extra.
No, el extra no cuenta, es de terminar justo a tiempo.
Cabal. Tiene ventajas y desventajas, correcto.
Sí, una es el tráfico, el que evito nada más y no salir de casa, ¿verdad? Pero igual es menos estrés también porque ya esas dos horas de traslado de la oficina a casa, así que cuesta.
Correcto, así que se ahorra lo que no hace de tráfico lo hace a veces en la casa de trabajo.
Cabal,
ahí lo balancea.
Hay días relajados.
Correcto. Okay. So Laura, do you have questions for me?
Bueno, a mí me cuesta un poco la pronunciación, teacher.
Pronunciation.
Okay.
Si usted quiere.
Podemos leer
el paragraph que vimos del manager. We could read that. ¿Se acuerda que vimos un párrafo de un manager? Well, the managers. Let me. This one. Era un reading.
El que estaba algo. The communicator que nos dejó tarea. Pero es que de la unidad 1 era. Ok. Ok, este está bien largo, teacher. Si quieres repasemos.
Ok, I'm going to start and then it's your turn. Voy a empezar yo para que me escuche y ya luego ya paso con usted.
Está bien.
Ok, number one, be a people person. North South is people and we are looking for managers who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know how people work and know how to motivate your team. If you are better with computers than people and understand Klingon better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial team. Okay, Laura, now it is your turn.
Okay, number one, be a people person. Noxor is people and we are looking for manager who likes people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know who people were and know how to motivate your team. If you are better with computer than people and understand Klingon better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial team.
Okay, thank you, Laura. Good pronunciation. I'm just going to help you with some words. Okay, the one you see here. And this one, we will check it. And the one you see here. Okay, so number one is managers.
Managers.
Uh-huh, managers.
Managers.
Correct. Okay. And this one again, Laura?
Constable.
Comfortable.
Comfortable. Comfortable. Comfortable. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's the pronunciation.
Con R en el medio.
Ajá.
Comfortable.
Es como que hubieran tres sonidos. El primero es conf, con F al final. Conf. Luego el segundo sería así. Tra.
Ah, tra. Ok. Comfortable.
Y lo último es ball. Y luego los une. Comfortable.
Okay. Comfortable.
Mm-hmm. That's the one. Managerial.
Managerial. Managerial. Como la sube y baja de la managerial. Managerial or managerial team. Or managerial team.
Okay. Our
managerial team.
Managerial. Let's try again, Laura. Leámoslo otra vez. One more time, okay. Please.
Number one, be a people person. Not sorry, people, and we are looking for managers. Okay. Who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know who people were and know who to motivate your team. If you are better with computers than people and understand Klingon better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial team.
Managerial.
Managerial. Hay que leer eso como el sonido. Managerial. Ajá. Managerial team, ok.
Ajá. Y como lo difícil a veces del inglés es que para un hispano, nosotros leemos todo así como está, ¿verdad? O sea, cada palabra, pero en inglés, no porque se escriba así es que se va a decir así.
No, y la fuerza de la voz, de la sílaba tiene un son, o sea, un bajo, alto, ¿cómo? Y bajo.
Ajá.
O sea, para saber qué momento. Por él decía yo managerial, pero es
managerial, es cierto.
Managerial,
como el
managerial team.
Y lo otro difícil es de que nosotros tenemos el acento, ¿verdad? Que aunque uno no conozca una palabra, pero cuando uno ve el acento, uno dice, ah, aquí le voy a dar más fuerza.
Sí.
Pero en inglés no trae tampoco acento.
Tiene que aprendérselo de memoria, teacher.
Correct. Tiene que aprenderse las palabras que hay. Entonces, ajá, otra vez, esto sería managers. Comfortable.
Managerial.
En this one, no sé si las dijo así la primera vez, pero cuando decimos esa, la D es silent. D is silent. Suena así cuando uno lo dice.
Should.
Ajá.
Should be comfortable.
Ajá, así suena.
Comfortable.
Okay, let's try again, Laura.
Okay.
The same paragraph.
El primero.
Okay. Yes.
Number one, be a people person. Noxor is a people and we are looking for managers. Who like people. You should be comfortable with conflict resolution. You should know who people were and know who to motivate your team. if you are better with computer than people and understand Klingon better than English, you are not a good fit for our managerial. Me olvidé el sonido.
Managerial team. Managerial. Okay. It happens, no se preocupe, hasta a mí hay unas palabras que se me olvida y lo oigo y lo oigo y no se me queda. Hay unas palabras que solo le cuestan a uno, so don't worry.
Está bien, teacher.
So, managerial. Managers. Esto es como que fueran familia. Managers, managerial. Vienen como del misma rama. Recuerda, esto es should. Y la que está acá es
comfortable.
Y esta que está acá es how.
How. Ah, yo dije hood, vea, pero no.
How, creo que dijo, pero.
I
think we will stop there. I don't know if there is something else you want to ask. ¿Alguna duda antes que cierre la sesión?
No, teacher. Estoy bien. Solo una duda extra, es la cosa, sí tengo. ¿La tarea de ahorita la vamos a terminar ya para mandársela?
No, yo les mencionaba que si no la han terminado, termínenla cuando ya les quede más chance o me la mandan en el fin de semana. Porque yo sé que todos trabajan,
¿verdad? Es que vi que lo dijo todo en inglés, pero dijo que lo iba a dar tiempo hasta después, dije yo, pero no entendí muy bien. O sea, ok, teacher. Entonces estamos bien, teacher. La vamos a terminar para dársela en esta semana, digamos.
Ok, sounds cool. Okay, Laura, have a good night.
Thank you, teacher. Un gusto.
You're welcome. Goodbye.
You're welcome.